In this video, you'll learn how to set up your Shopify shipping rates so by the end of it, you can start fulfilling your orders and avoid losing any money on delivery. We'll go over the different shipping options available on Shopify and how to set them up, how to choose the right shipping rate to avoid losing money, and finally, how to create shipping labels that you can print out and stick on your packages ready to be sent to your customer. Heaps of ways you can set up your shipping settings on Shopify, but to make things simple, I've grouped them into four main categories. The first category is the flat rate, where you can charge a fixed fee based on price or weight range. And then you've got calculated rates, where Shopify pulls in real-time shipping prices from your shipping provider at checkout based on your package size and how far away your customer is. There's also local delivery. So this is if you want to deliver the package yourself rather than get a carrier to do it for you. And there's also a pickup option, so your customers can collect their order in person if that's something that you offer. So now let's go through how to set up each of these, starting with flat rates. Okay, so from your dashboard, go to Settings, Shipping and Delivery. At the top, you'll see your shipping profiles. So in Shopify, a shipping profile is a way to customize your shipping rules for different types of products. By default, there's a shipping profile that applies to all products for both domestic and international shipping. Scroll down to see your shipping zones. These zones let you set up shipping rules by country. For example, here, I've got a flat rate of $20 for international. And for Australia, I've got free shipping for orders over $100, $10 for orders under $100, and $15 for express. So let's say you want to add a new rate for orders between $50 to $100. Click Add Rate and choose Flat Rate. Give it a name, I don't know, like Extra Express, and then click Add Conditions. Choose price-based conditions and set the range from $50 to $100. The preview at the bottom will show you what customers will see when they're at checkout, so that's super handy, and then hit done. I'm just gonna delete what I just created for the sake of the demo, but what if you want to set a different rate for a specific country? So for example, New Zealand. Currently, New Zealand is lumped into the international zone with a $20 fee. But anyway, let's fix that. Click Create New Shipping Zone. And Shopify will prompt you to go to the market settings. Create a new market for New Zealand by giving a name and selecting New Zealand on the list. Then go back to shipping settings. Edit your international zone and remove New Zealand from it. Now you can add New Zealand as a separate zone. This time, let's set up a calculated rate for New Zealand. So for calculated rates, Shopify uses Sendal, which is an international shipping provider that gives you the best live rates based on your customer's location and package size. And here at the bottom, you can also add a handling fee if you want to pad the price a little bit. Just make sure to check international under the shipping services. Now let's look at the other settings, including the last two delivery options. They've got this shipping label option, which I'll go through later, so stick around for that. You can also set up local deliveries down here. Just click into it, set the toggle to on, and then fill in the details. It works very much like the flat rate settings we just went over. Hit save when you're done, but I'll just disable it for this video. You can also enable store pickup. Just click into the options and follow the prompts if you want to set this up. You can also save your package sizes here. You'll need to set this up and select a default if you're using calculated shipping, because the shipping rates do depend on the size and the weight of your parcels.
So the question is, which shipping option should you use? It might seem like the most
boring setting to think about, but the truth is it can either make or break your sales. I mean, if you think about it, when was the last time you were ready to buy something, but then you see the shipping costs and you decide that it's not worth it? If shipping is too expensive, people abandon cart. If it's too generous, you lose money. And if it's too confusing, people give up altogether. So how do you win? I like to think of it as a balancing act between cost, profit, and customer psychology. I have a client that I think is balancing it really, really well. They're based here in Australia, but most of their customers are in the US. At the moment, they're making about $100,000 per month. So here's exactly what they did. First, they identified their primary markets, which is the US, Canada, Australia, and New Zealand. And for each of those countries, they set up a flat rate with tiered pricing and also set up a free shipping threshold based on how much people are spending on average. So that way, customers will be encouraged to add more to their cart. So that way, they're able to maximize their sales. For the rest of the countries in the world, like South America and Europe, which they don't really sell to, they just kept it simple and set up calculated shipping for each of those, so that way they don't lose money.
How do you get your products to your customer? First, I'd recommend making a test order to see what happens when a customer buys something. So let's set up test payments first so we won't get charged a cent for this exercise. Go to settings, payments, Shopify payments, then scroll all the way to the bottom and enable test payments. Then open up Shopify store in another tab. Add something to your cart and go to checkout. Once you're there, fill out all your details, and once you get to the part where you have to enter your credit card, enter any of these fake credit card details provided by Shopify, and then finish the checkout process. Okay, so that worked. Now you can go back to your dashboard and head over to orders. You can see an order's come through, so click on it. And whoops, we got an error up here because we haven't set up a shipping origin address. You can add one by going to settings, locations, add address here, and I'm gonna put my home address. So this is the location where you want your carrier to pick up your order. So this could be a warehouse, or if you're just starting out your business, your home. So now if I reload my order, the error is gone. From here, I'm gonna enter the size of my package and what type of package it is, because that determines how much shipping costs. Then you can create presets, which I've already done here. And then you can select whether you want the courier to pick it up from your location, or if you're going to drop it off to them to deliver to your customer. Let's select drop off. And finally, hit buy shipping label. It'll give you the confirmation, and then you can print out the shipping label and packing slip at the same time by checking this option. It'll open up as a PDF and you can print it out however you want. Once you print it out, you can put the packing slip inside of your package so it's like a receipt for your customer, and then stick the shipping label outside of your box for the courier. Just like that, you've completed your first order.
Now that you're ready to fulfill orders, the final step is to get a custom domain and connect it to your Shopify store so you can give it a unique URL. We're almost ready to start selling, guys, so stick with me for this last step by clicking this video, and I'll see you there.